I come to the garden.
Good morning.
Good morning.
We can do better than that. Good morning.
Good morning.
Wow. Happy Resurrection Sunday.
Yay.
Come on, y'all.
Good morning, Facebook family. Happy Resurrection Sunday to you as well.
Yes, Lord.
If you're thankful this morning, if you're grateful this morning, I need you to give God the highest praise. And Facebook family, I need you to put in a whole bunch of hearts and then type on the timeline, hallelujah. Can we do that this morning?
Yes.
So if you're grateful or thankful, I need you to Shabbat God this morning.
Hallelujah.
Listen, they say the stone was rolled and the tomb is empty.
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
Yes,
hallelujah.
Lord.
Hallelujah.
He has risen.
Yes, Lord.
On this resurrection Sunday.
Yes.
For my babies, they say, it's Easter Sunday, prophetess. Yes, it is. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hallelujah. We're so grateful and thankful to see you all out this morning. And for those that have tapped in online, we know you could have been at a lot of other places, but you choose to break bread with us. So we want to say we're honored, we're grateful, and thank you so much. Amen?
Amen.
I'm going to read a familiar psalm, Psalms 100, King James Version. I know y'all know this by heart, but, you know, today is even more of a day to be grateful. Amen?
Amen.
Verse 1 says, make a joyful noise.
Yeah. Yeah.
Make a joyful noise.
Hallelujah.
Unto the Lord. Lord.
Yes.
All ye lands.
Yes, yes.
Serve the Lord with gladness.
Yes.
Come before his presence
Hallelujah.
With singing.
Yes.
Know ye that the Lord,
yes.
He is good.
Yes.
I'm sorry, he is God.
Yes.
It is he that has made us. And not we ourselves. We are his people.
Yes.
I need y'all to say,
we are his people.
And the sheep of his pasture. And then it says, enter his gates with thanksgiving.
Hallelujah.
And into his courts with praise. It says, be thankful unto him.
Yes, Lord.
And bless his name. Everlasting, and his truth endureth to all generations. It don't say some generation. It don't say certain generations. It says to all generations. We want to have blessing of the reading of God's word. I pray that you allow root to take from Psalms 100 on today. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. And then we're going to do announcements. And after the announcements, we're going to take communion this Sunday. Hallelujah.
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 And then from there, we'll have the wonderful praise team.
Amen, amen.
And after that, we're going to have a mighty word of God from our very own Pastor Tony Jenkins.
Yes.
Yes, God, yes, God. I'm telling you, something's going on already.
Yes,
I feel it.
Yes, Lord.
I already feel it,
yes,
y'all.
Lord.
I'm telling you.
Hallelujah.
You need to be thanking him.
Yes, God. Yes.
You need to be thanking him.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you,
Lord.
Amen. I want to say happy birthday to all the April babies.
Woo!
On Friday, we had a baby in our house, and she's not a baby no more, so right, I gotta check baby. Myself.
Uh-oh.
A young lady, mm-hmm. her name is Miss Jada, mm-hmm. and her birthday was on Friday. Hey. Come on up, Jada. Happy birthday. Hey. Our very own Jada. How old did you turn, Miss Jada?
15.
She's a whole 15. We got us another high school. Age of 15
yes,
in this season. Amen.
Amen.
So happy blessed birthday to Jada and
yes.
all the April babies. Anybody yes. else got a birthday in April?
My Joyce.
Yeah, I'm about to say Elder Joyce's birthday is on the
22nd.
All right. So for those that have her number or on Facebook, make sure y'all hit the woman of God up and Shabbat her for her birthday.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
She will be 25 years old.
All yes. right.
Subscribe with us on Facebook or YouTube and continue to follow us. Amen.
Yes.
We're going to continue to pray for the coronavirus that all the victims will be healed, the families will come together, and that God will come up with a cure. Amen.
Yes, yes.
We're also praying for those who lost a loved one due to the virus. We're praying for our very own Angelica and Terry. They're traveling from Myrtle Beach with the babies. So we're praying travel, grace, and mercy for them in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
Also continue to lift up our very own Serena to make sure she continue to have a very healthy pregnancy.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
They will be doing, I think, next month, the revealing of the gender. Amen.
Amen.
Also stay on the wall for the low self-esteem and depression. Y'all know staying in the house, some people are getting out more, but it's still a challenge. So please, please, please lift those up, whoever God gives you their faith.
Yes.
Or even if you just came to pray, add that in your prayers. Amen.
Yes.
Continue to pray for our kids and all the adults in school for head of protection.
Yes.
The kids should be getting out of school within, the next 30 days? So let's also add them to our prayer list for them to have an amazing, wonderful,
yes.
safe summer as well. Amen.
Yes.
Also pray for anyone with sinus challenges, scratchy throat, cold
yes.
symptoms,
yes.
COVID,
yes.
or pneumonia. Also
yes.
continue
yes.
to pray
yes.
for the bereaved families, first responders, doctors, nurses, hospital workers, ambulance drivers, EMT, store workers, trash collectors, mailmen and associates, hotel reps, restaurant and employees. Also continue to pray for President Joe Biden, Vice President Carmela Harris, all widows and widowers, homeless, government officials, troops, law enforcement. Pray for the pastors here at Bishop's Amen,
yes.
pastors all over the world. Pray for leaders here in ministry and leaders all over the world.
Yes.
Please continue to pray for one another.
Yes.
Amen?
Amen.
I'm going to say that again. Please continue to pray for one another.
Amen.
Amen. Also pray for our nation and our world. And then I want to give a very, very, very thank you to all of you that have been faithful in your giving, your tithes, your offerings, your love seeds. Thank you so much. We're praying that God will give you a blessing upon you that you won't even have room to receive it. Amen?
Amen.
So at this time, if you would like to give, Miss Jada's going to take the basket since she's already up here.
Yeah, right.
And then she can go around. And then after that, when she comes back, for those that can, we would like for you to put something in her envelope so we can bless her, because her birthday was on Friday. She turned a whole 15. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. And also our spiritual mom, Apostle Sandra Randolph, Wilmington, North Carolina. Her birthday was this past week. She's still celebrating for the whole month.
Amen.
But anyone that knows her, send her a shout out.
Amen.
You can mail her something. You can cash out, or it ain't too late. Amen?
Amen.
Her and I are playing a game right now, so I'm curious to see how this is going to go. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Is that everyone?
No.
Amen, amen, amen. Amen. We want to say good morning to everyone again. Thank you. I got two or more of my babies in the house today. He ain't going to say much, but I'm going to have to take them back up on another challenge of pool.
Uh-oh.
I'm I'm going to call him out this morning.
Uh-oh.
We're happy to see you guys. He's like, every time she see me, she always talking about poop. He beat me, but it's okay. You know I got to try to at least try to come back. Got to be a comeback kid, okay? Okay. Come on, comeback chick today. Amen.
Amen.
If we can stand and point our right hand to the basket. Father God, we thank you right now for this Super Sunday, oh God. We thank God that you rose again, Lord.
Yes.
Lord, bless the basket for everyone that gave and everyone that had the desire to give, God, but they may not have had it. So, Lord, right now we're thanking that you are already breaking the spirit of brokenness,
yes,
the spirit of poverty. And God, we're loosing right now that you're going to give them an overflow, that they won't have room to receive it. Monies and deposits just going to start coming in the mailbox, popping up in the bank accounts, hitting the cash out. Even those that owe us, God, we're calling them forth now that you will have to touch their heart and release back to us what they owe us. So, Lord, we thank you for the seeds that were sown this morning. We give you all the honor and all the praise. In Jesus' name, amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Amen. All right. For those that can, I want to hand this to Jada.
Jada, you got to
get
that.
Then you can come up there and bless her for those that can.
Yes.
Amen. Do Jada have a cash
out? I asked her if she's going to me.
I said no.
Oh, okay.
All right,
amen. We're going to bless her for her birthday. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Again, happy birthday, Jada.
Yay.
Happy birthday!
Thank you.
And so, all right, Pastor, what's going on over here? I need your help, Pastor. I don't know what's going on. My thing just went blank. Hold on. Let's try it again. Okay. All right. Got it. Yep. All right. So, also for those that are interested in giving today, you can cash up us at $FISHERSOFMENICM. That's $FishersOfMen, ICM, where you can use the number 678-886-8117. If you like to Zelle, the number for Zelle is 404-680-6796. And if you want to send by PayPal, it's paypal.me/JENKMO. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. And again, happy, happy birthday to all the April babies.
Yay.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. At this time, if I could have Elder Daniels and Elder Chisholm to come forth, please. We're going to do communion this morning. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah.
surrender to you. In your presence, as your speech, it's flowing. You can not only in my mind, but in my mind. In my conception, in my perception, that I may serve you, that you may be glorified. And my soul says yes to you. Come on, let's sing it. My soul says yes.
And get everyone a hand, please. If I can get everyone to stand. Father God, in the name of Jesus, God, we thank you right now for your presence in this house, oh God. And we thank you for just blessing us with all the people that showed up this morning. God, you know what each and every one of us have need of. So we thank you in advance that you've already blessed us with it. So God, we speak peace right now to each and every person on the side of my voice. We speak restoration, God, to everyone on the side of my voice. We speak joy, all the fruits of the Spirit, long-suffering, self-control, in the mighty name of Jesus. God, we just honor you and we thank you for such a wonderful day because we all know, and we're touching the ground, God, that you rose.
Right.
On the third day that you rose. So God, we thank you for rising to save each and every one of us, for forgiving all of us of our sin, oh God. So God, even now, as we take petition this morning, oh God, that it would change the thoughts of our mind, oh God. That it would change the way that we feel about certain people, God. And it would just make us just be loving and caring for each and every one of your children in the name of Jesus. So God, I ask that anyone that still has aught with one or another, that as they take bread this morning, God, that they will forgive those that did them wrong or lied on them or mistreated them, God, in the name of Jesus. And that, God, they will walk in peace like never before, in the mighty name of Jesus. So God, let your Holy Spirit take over this morning. Have your way, God, in this place, in the mighty name of Jesus. And God, we give you all the honor and all the praise this morning. In Jesus' name, amen.
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 Hallelujah. I'm going to be reading to you one this morning from 1 Corinthians chapter 11. And I'm going to actually start with verse 23 through 30. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. It says, "For I have received of the Lord that which also I delivered unto you, that the Lord Jesus, the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread.
Yes.
And when he had given thanks, he break it." Everybody can break it. "And said, take, eat, this is my body, which is broken for you. This do in remembrance of me." Amen?
Amen.
Amen. "After the same manner, also he took the cup when he had supped, saying, this cup is the New Testament in my blood. This do ye as oft as ye drink it in remembrance of me. For as often as ye eat this bread and drink this cup, ye do shew the Lord's death till he come. Wherefore, whosoever shall eat this bread and drink this cup of the Lord unworthily shall be guilty of the body and blood of the Lord. But let a man examine himself, and so let him eat of that bread and drink of that cup. For he that eateth and drinketh unworthily eateth and drinketh damnation to himself, not discouraging the Lord's body. For this cause many are weak and sickly among you, and may sleep. For if we would judge ourselves, we should not be judged. But when we are judged, we are chastened of the Lord, that we should not be condemned with the world. Wherefore, my brethren, when you come together to eat, tarry one for another. And if any man hunger, let him eat at home, that you come not together into a condemnation." So at this time, if you would please drink the blood. Amen. And it says, "At the end, at the rest, will I set in order when I come." Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Holy Spirit say forgive.
I don't know who I'm talking to, but God said forgive. And it may be someone on Facebook Live. So if you have aught with somebody, I don't care if it was 10 years ago, 5 weeks ago, 5 months ago, 7 years ago, amen. Y'all please forgive them. You know, I know back in the day they used to take stuff to the grave and be mad with each other. Don't do that. God loves us even in our mess. So if he's given us grace, then we need to give our sisters and brothers in Christ grace. So if you ever got aught with somebody, just text them if you don't want to hear their voice to talk to them. Just tell them, I forgive you. It don't matter if they receive it or not.
Amen.
You just want to make sure you clear your heart up right with God. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. I love y'all. Amen. But we are here to love. Amen.
Yes.
No matter what, let's just love.
Yes.
If we focus on loving each other,
come on.
We'll be so busy that it'll take us the rest of our blessed lives to focus on love.
Yes.
Can we scream love?
Love!
Facebook fam, I need you to type love, L-O-V-E, because that's what it's all about, y'all.
Amen.
Nothing extra, nothing taken away,
right.
Just simple, L-O-V-E.
Amen.
There are a lot of commandments, but if you focus on that one,
yes.
I promise you, hey, everything will fall in place, amen?
Amen.
And then at this time, we're going to have a praise team to come and bless us with two songs, and then we're going to hear from our very own pastor, Tony Jenkins, amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. Okay, so everybody already know he got up. Amen?
Amen.
He did right.
He really
made me nervous. It got real quiet in here.
Risen.
Everybody knows.
Come on now. Right.
He got up.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, yes, yes,
yes.
Yes,
ma'am.
But do you know about the process that led up to that?
Thank you.
I know you've read it in your earlier years. If you were anything like the Baptist church that I grew up in, read it in your early years. In fact, you read it so much from the King James Version. There were days when you were probably more confused than you were enlightened. But as you grew and you began to understand and you began to pray and ask the Lord himself to show you exactly what that means, everything looks different. Amen?
Amen.
So you know he got up, but do you know about everything that led up to that?
Yes.
Or why he was placed in a position to get up in the first place?
Yes.
What exactly, what happened to where he was put in the position to where he hung, bled, and died for you and me. Suffered death, hell, and the grave.
Yes, Lord.
And then got up. It's interesting how every resurrection Sunday, we focus on him getting up. But the Lord told me this time that we need to say thank you.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Because even if you don't know why he was put in that position in the first place, I could tell you. But I would feel so much better if you would look it up and do
amen.
Some
research. Amen.
Even though you don't know, you may not know. I can't say, forgive me, I did not mean to assume that you did not know. You may not know why he was placed in that position. There was a particular song written about a portion of that incense several years back. And the woman of God that sang it, wrote it, the Lord blessed her with it. When she sang it, it hit my spirit so heavy that I could not do anything but to cry out and to just dig even deeper into why he was placed in that position to begin with. Amen.
Amen.
But when you do your research and you find out that he was not placed in that position. He volunteered. Yes, he
come on.
He volunteered. He said, I need to go save Elder Little. I know it's years coming down the pipe, but I need to make sure that she has exactly what
my
she
God,
needs.
My God.
Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you. When she needs it.
Yes, Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
I need to go save Sister Jocelyn.
Yes, Lord.
I need to do this just for her. Because you know what? She's one of my favorites. Yes, I know I said I'm not a respectable person, and I'm not. You're my favorite. You're my favorite.
Yes, Lord.
You're my favorite.
Yes, Lord.
In the name of Jesus.
Yes,
and one woman understood what that meant. She understood the selflessness that it took for what appeared to be this one man to give all that he had for you. She understood that. She knew that there was absolutely nothing she could do that would even come close to paying him back. Nothing that she could give him to pay him back, right?
Amen.
So with a broken heart, with a humbled heart, she got up, went to the church. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And gave what she felt was the, that was the best she could do. That was the best I had. Lord, I have nothing else. I give you this. Amen. That's too high for me. Y'all can tell by the way Elder Little cracking up over there. It's okay. It's okay. That's so much better. Hallelujah. But I really need for you to research and understand not only what happened leading up to that, but I need for you to understand where
you did not feel what I felt when he wrapped me in.
to the sin that had me bound. I spent my days pouring my life without measure into the treasure box I thought I'd found. Until the day when Jesus came to me, healed my soul. Or what you think you know about them that they've gone through or have not gone through. Hallelujah. You know the cost of the oil in your box.
Yeah.
Honestly, how much do you know about them and the oil in their box?
Yes, Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
You don't know the cost.
Amen.
You don't know the cost. Hallelujah.
Oh, God.
And from where we are today and where we're celebrating, the day that we're celebrating, could you put a price on that?
No.
My God.
In all honesty, could you put a price on that? Would you even want to?
No.
Would you want to say anything other than, thank you, Jesus?
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you,
Jesus.
Thank you.
Hallelujah.
Thank you. Hallelujah.
I'm not doing this on purpose, y'all. Hallelujah. 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 How awesome he is. Amen. Hallelujah. Yes, Jesus. Come on. Yes, Jesus.
Your love for me.
There we go.
You're so amazing. Your sacrifice for me.
Let's think about it.
For every blessing.
Yes, God. Thank you, Jesus.
He's given unto me.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
For every life you used to strengthen me. Deserve your love, your tender mercy.
Hallelujah. Your love for me is so amazing.
Your sacrifice for me.
For every blessing.
Yes, yes, yes.
Give unto me.
Yes, Lord, yes, Lord.
For every valley you used to strengthen.
God has been good to us. He's been better to us than we've been to ourselves. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. We're so happy to have so many of you to fellowship with us this morning. Amen. Amen. I'm so happy to see my brother Kurt in the house with us. And my daughter Jocelyn. Hallelujah. We're so happy to have y'all to worship and fellowship with us today. I have my niece Aaliyah Johnson in the house today. Thank you, baby, for coming to fellowship with us. With us, my sister, Annette Johnson. We're so happy to have you in the house today, baby. Thank you for coming. Amen. We thank God for those of you who are joining us on our Facebook Live. Hallelujah. We thank God for you. We don't take it lightly. We don't take it for granted that you chose to worship and fellowship with us. We pray that this experience that you're going to experience this day would be an everlasting change, experience, transformation in your life. Amen. Amen. Glory to God. Anybody excited about Jesus today? think we would have anybody in the house excited about Jesus today. Y'all on Silent Night got y'all too excited about your day. Good God of mine. He paid the ultimate sacrifice for you.
Yes,
hallelujah. He deserved the greatest praise. He deserves your very best.
Hallelujah.
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 Thank you, Jesus. I'm already wound up already. I'm excited. I come to the house with the spirit of expectation. I'm expecting a mighty move of God this day. Not just for myself, but for you too. Amen. Amen. On this awesome resurrection Sunday.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
I thank God for what Jesus done.
Yes, Lord.
Just for me and you.
Yes.
Let us pray. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we thank you. We praise you. We honor you, Father. We thank you for this great and awesome day, God. We've never seen this day. But God, we're going to rejoice and be glad in it. Father, you said in everything, give thanks. So God, we come with the spirit of thanksgiving, giving you thanks, giving you praise, giving you glory, and giving you honor for everything that's already transpired and what's going to transpire with your word coming forth, Father. Holy Spirit, we welcome you into this atmosphere. Saturate this atmosphere with your presence. Dear God, don't let no one leave the same way they came, Father. Let this be such an experience, dear God, experience of you, Father God, in the name of Jesus. God, those that need a healing, heal, dear God. Those that need a deliverance, dear God, deliver them, Father God. Those that need a financial breakthrough, dear God. Oh, God, touch somebody's heart, dear God, that they will reach out and pour into their life, dear God, in the name of Jesus, God. Now, Father, decrease me now. Let the spirit man take full control and full reign. Let the words that come out of my mouth be not those of my own, but you're speaking through me with power, might, and authority, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Come on, put those Holy Ghost hands together one more time. Giving God a hand clap of praise, for he is truly worthy. He's truly worthy. I think he's truly worthy to be praised. Oh, yes, he is. Yes, he is. Yes, he is. When he did what he did it with you in mind. When he went to the cross, he went there with you in mind. Amen. Amen. If I could use for a topic today, rose in three. He rose in three. Hallelujah. Come on, somebody get excited about that.
Yes, hallelujah.
Not even the grave could hold him.
Yeah.
Death could hold him. Hallelujah.
Woo. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Just for me and you.
Yeah.
I'm going to be reading from Matthew chapter 16, verse 21. Amplified version. Matthew chapter 16, verse 21 from the Amplified. Amen. I got quite a few scriptures today, but this is one I'm starting out with.
Amen.
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 Amen. Y'all have it?
Yeah.
Amen. From that time on, Jesus began to show his disciples clearly that he must go to Jerusalem and endure many things at the hands of the elders and the chief priests and scribes, Sanhedrin, Jewish high court, and be killed and be raised from death to life on the third day. To be raised from death to life on the third day. There's something significant about that number three.
Yes.
Father, Son, and the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord.
Powerful number. Powerful number. Three. Rose on the third day. He rose with all power in his hands. Not just power on earth, but power in the heavens and in the earth realm. All power in his hands, didn't he? Just for me and you. Glory to God. But y'all better get excited about Jesus, I'm telling you.
Amen.
Amen. We got a lot to be excited about. People be saying, it don't take all of that. No, baby, it take all that and some. Trust me, that enemy is busy doing his business, doing his job. You better get busy by doing God's job. Bible says he's going to and fro, seeing who he may devour. You think he don't want to devour you?
Come on.
Ooh, Jesus. Rose in three. Rose in three. I need to paint this graphic picture of some of what Jesus had to endure just for me and you. Good God Almighty.
Yes,
God. I need to make it as graphic as possible so you could understand exactly what Jesus went through.
Yes, come on.
In Isaiah chapter 52, 13 through 15, it says that they beat him so bad that he didn't even look human.
My God.
He took a beating just for me and you. He didn't look human. They beat him so bad. Jesus. A ruined face, disfigured beyond recognition. They mocked him in Matthew so that they put a crown of thorns on his head. I'm a country boy. If you know anything about thorns from walking in the woods, once one of them thorns poke you, buddy, them things hurt. And they made a crown and placed it on his head. They made a sign that they put at the top of the cross that said, "Here, King of the Jews. Hail, King of the Jews." They was mocking him. That didn't mean that he was the king of the Jews. You know that, right? They was mocking him by saying this.
Thank you, Lord.
They made him carry his own cross.
Yes, Lord.
Yes.
After beating him beyond recognition, they made him carry his own cross. The cross got so heavy for him to bear that a brother had to come help him out. Y'all walk with me now. Walk with me. They put nails in his hands and his feet. They nailed him to the cross. They didn't just tie him to the cross. They nailed his hands and his feet to the cross. I got to make this thing graphic now. Y'all let your mind go with me today and imagine how that must have felt, what he had to endure. Just for me and you.
Yes.
They took a spear and pierced him in his side to make sure that he was dead.
Yes.
Jesus. They hung him between two robbers. They treated him as if he was a sinner too. And they placed him in the middle of them. Good God Almighty. Hung him. I got to make it graphic now. Isaiah 53, 4 through 7 says, amplified also, Isaiah 53, 4 through 7, but in fact, he has borne our griefs.
Yes.
And he has carried our sorrows and pain.
Yes.
Yet, we, somebody say yet.
Yes.
Yet we ignorantly assumed that he was stricken, struck down by God, and degraded and humiliated by him. This is what the Jewish people was thinking. That God was punishing his son. But, somebody say but.
But.
He was wounded for our transgressions. He was crushed for our wickedness, our sin, our injustice, our wrongdoing. The punishment required for our well-being fell on him. And by his stripes, wounds, we are healed. All those beatings and all those stripes that he took just for me and you, just so that you would be healed.
Thank you, Lord.
Not just physically, mentally, emotionally, spiritually, total healing. From the crown of your head to the soles of your feet. I know some of y'all got some aches and pains going on today. But I speak to those areas right now in the name of Jesus. I take full authority, full power over those aches and pains right now. I command it to come up on you right now in the name of Jesus. By his stripes, you are already healed in the name of Jesus. Be healed and made whole from the crown of your head to the soles of your feet. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Yes.
All of us, like sheep, have gone astray.
Yes.
We have turned each one to his own way.
Yes, God.
But the Lord has caused the wickedness of us all, our sin, our injustice, our wrongdoing, to fall on him instead of falling on us.
Yes.
What a loving God we serve. When he went to the cross, he had you in mind.
Yes.
He had me in mind. Yes.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord. Thank
my
you,
God.
Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
We got so much to be grateful for.
Yes,
so much to be thankful for.
Yes, Lord.
We take it for granted what Jesus did on our behalf, y'all.
Yes. Yes, yes.
Verse 7. He was oppressed and he was afflicted, yet he did not open his mouth to complain or defend himself. Don't you know that he had all the power to call legions of angels down and destroy all of them? But no, he didn't murmur nor did he complain. He knew that he was on a mission from his daddy, from God. Amen. And like a sheep that is silent before her shearers, so he did not open his mouth. The Bible said he never murmured or complained. He said, it is finished.
Yes, yes, yes.
It is finished. Everything that Jesus did on earth is finished.
Yes.
Then he hung his head and died.
Yes.
The Bible says he gave up the ghost. They didn't take the ghost. He gave up the ghost. He had power to keep the ghost, but he gave up the ghost.
Yes.
Come on, Pastor.
They placed his body in a tomb and rolled a huge stone in front of it. They blocked the entrance, right? Yeah. They thought they was trying to keep him on the inside of the tomb because they had got word that he said in 3 days, three days, I'm coming up. I'm getting up from this grave. I'm coming up out of this tomb in 3 days.
Look for me.
They thought a little measly little stone was going to keep him from coming up out of there. And we're talking about a God that got all power.
Come on.
My
Lord.
My God.
On the third day, just as Jesus had told him, he rose from the dead. Hallelujah. When they found out that Jesus had rose, just like he had said, they paid soldiers to lie.
Lord.
Yeah, they did.
They paid him to lie and told him that his followers them came and stole him in the middle of the night.
Lord.
Just to discredit what he had said before he died.
Jesus.
They still didn't know what had happened. All they know, he was no longer in that tomb. Jesus. Yeah. Turn with me to John 20. John chapter 20. Rose in three, y'all. He rose in three. With all power in his hands.
Yes.
Ooh, boy.
Yes, Lord.
We tend to want to try to depend on mama and them.
Come on.
Daddy and them. Grandmama and them.
Mm-hmm.
And we have a daddy like Jesus who has all the power. Who's all knowing and all seeing.
Yes.
That knows everything that you got going on in your life. And you want to depend and lean back on somebody else that don't even have a clue, that's playing the guessing game.
Yes.
John 20, 1 through 9, Amplified.
Yes, Lord.
John chapter 20, 1 through 9. Now on the first day of the week, Mary Magdalene came to the tomb early while it was still dark and saw the stone already removed from the groove across the entrance of the tomb. So she ran and went to Simon Peter and to the other disciples, John, whom Jesus loved, esteemed, and said to them, they have taken away the Lord out of the tomb, and we do not know where they had laid him. Now, Mary and them knew Jesus. They knew what the word that Jesus had gave them, that on day three that he was going to rise. Even though they walked with him, even though they talked with him, even though they saw him do all kind of miracles, signs and wonders and supernatural things, they still had doubt in their heart and didn't believe what he had told them when it pertained to them rising on the third day. So when she came to the tomb and saw the stone rolled away, she was heartbroken. Feeling bad, crying. Running to go tell her brothers what she had saw. So Peter and the other disciples, verse 3, left, and they were going to the tomb. And the two were running together, but the other disciple outran Peter and arrived at the tomb first. Stooping down and looking in, he saw the linen wrappings neatly lying there, but he did not go in. So not only did Jesus come up out of them old nasty old dirty clothes, he didn't just throw them on the ground and leave them. He neatly folded them up and wrapped them up. Then Simon Peter came up following him and went into the tomb and saw the linen wrappings neatly lying there and the burial face cloth that had been on Jesus' head not lying with the other linen wrappings but rolled up in a place all by itself. Why do you think that Jesus had the face wrapping in a different location than what he had the rest of the wrapping?
I don't know. It only could be God.
Hallelujah. Yes. Ooh, boy.
Come on, Pastor.
Only Jesus.
Only Jesus.
He was just trying to get up out of there.
Yes.
Yes, sir. So the other disciple who had reached the tomb first went in too, and he saw the wrappings and the face cloth and believed without any doubt that Jesus had risen from the dead. Without a shadow of a doubt. That means he had no doubt in his heart or his mind. That he knew that Jesus did exactly what he said he was going to do. For as yet, they did not understand the scripture that he must rise from the dead. They still didn't understand it at that particular time, even though he didn't have a doubt that he had rose from the dead. The Bible says that they still didn't understand the scripture. They still had some kind of misunderstanding going on in their mind. Could it be that they were trying to see things that were spiritual with the natural eye?
Absolutely.
I'm almost done too. In closing, he rose in 3 days just like he told the disciples he would do.
Amen.
He took a gruesome beating and died a gruesome death just for you and me. For the sins of the world, to bring us back in right relationship with God, to be able to do what the first Adam couldn't do.
Amen.
Amen. The original Adam was born here designed for us to live holy and upright. But he took his eyes off the prize.
He
lost focus.
Yes.
Like so many of us do, we tend to lose focus and take our eyes off the prize.
Come on, Pastor, preach.
In this season of your life, you've got to remain focused on the things of God. And keep your eyes on the prize, which is in Christ Jesus. The mark of the high calling. Keep your eyes on the prize. Stay focused. Stay focused, men and women, God. Stay focused on what's beforehand. You got to be like that mule with those blinders. I was saying it Wednesday. A mule has blinders on his eyes where he can only look straight ahead. He ain't thinking about what's going on behind him.
Come on,
Holy Ghost. Like so many of us, we're so concerned with what's going on back there. All around you. And it causes you to lose the focus on what's ahead of you. Oh, boy. Then you have the enemy on top of that. Will send somebody your way from your past.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
And they'll try to remind you of who you used to be. They'll talk to you as if you are still that same person that you was when you was a child.
Right.
Jesus. Instead of growing up and maturing in the things of God, they want to still live in their past. A place that they're not even at no more. But they want to bring you back to that place. They want to remind you of the things you used to do when you was back there, instead of trying to find out what you got going on today. What you got going on in your life right now, right this very moment. And they'll use peer pressure too. Some of y'all fall into that peer pressure. That's my friend. I don't want to let my friend down. Instead of you telling that friend that they're a true friend, that's the old me. I don't do those things no more. I don't go those places no more. I don't talk like that no more. What a loving Father we serve. What a loving Savior that we have. He did all of these things because he loves us.
Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Y'all didn't get that, baby.
Yes. Thank you, Jesus.
Y'all didn't get that. He did it just because he loved you and me. John 3:16 says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth on him should not perish, but have everlasting life." Jesus made it where you could have eternal life.
Hallelujah.
Eternal life. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus, for rising in three. He rose in 3 days, y'all. I said he rose in 3 days. Just for me and you. I'm reminded of how when I was a kid, we used to do Easter speeches. Anybody can bear witness to that. Whenever you was a kid, you used to do Easter speeches and you used to do those plays. Easter plays.
Yes.
Every you dress up in your Sunday best.
Every
Easter. If you might not go to church no other day, but on Easter, you're going to have on your Easter best and you're going to give that speech. You're going to go to rehearsal and rehearse with that speech, and you're going to rehearse with that play. I don't know about y'all. I grew up in a Baptist church. And you better believe they're going to be doing that Easter speech. And we're going to do that Easter play.
Yes.
It was fun now. Easter, don't believe about the Easter egg hunt. I don't. I'm surprised y'all ain't say nothing about the Easter egg hunt and the Easter bunny. Y'all forgot all about the true reason why we was celebrating.
Right.
All of a sudden now it's been made about the bunny. About the candy. And forgot all about Jesus. The one who made the ultimate sacrifice.
Jesus, yes, yes.
I wrote this speech, y'all.
Come on now. Come on now.
I wrote an Easter speech. A resurrection speech. Yeah. The title of it is Rose in Three. Goes, y'all. It says, Jesus died for you and me. He rose from the dead on day three. Mary came to the tomb to visit Jesus. The angel asked her, "What do you see?" The tomb was empty because Jesus was gone. Hallelujah, glory to God. He rose from the dead on day three, just for you and just for me. Happy Resurrection Day. Amen. Come on, please. Amen. Anybody excited about Resurrection Sunday? Are y'all excited about what Jesus did for me and you? Hallelujah. Glory to God. He brought us back in right relationship with our dad.
Yes.
Amen. Other than that, the Bible said the only way to get to the Father is through the Son.
Yes, Lord.
So thank God for what Jesus did just for me and you. Father God, in the name of Jesus, I thank you, I praise you, and I honor you, Father. I thank you for this Resurrection Sunday, Father. I thank you that Jesus was raised from the dead on day three. God, I pray, dear God, that we would get it in our spirit, dear God, and understand what Jesus had to endure just for you and me. God, I pray, dear God, that we would take our walk seriously, God. I pray, dear God, that you would release your anointing, release your power, release your glory on everyone under the sound of my voice, Father, like never before, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. God, bless us now, God. God, you know all about each and every one, Father. God, you say you know us before we was ever in our mother's womb. You say you know us by the number of hairs that are upon our heads, God. So, God, I know you know everything about us, Father God. So, God, meet our every need, want, and desire in this season, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, whatever they might be, God. Oh, God, I know that you said you'll never leave us nor forsake us, God. God, you said, lo, I am with you always, even until the ends of the world. So, Father, I know you're with us every step of the way. Continue to lead us, guide us, and order our steps, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. I'm thanking you in advance, Father, that everything that transpired throughout this service, God, I thank you for your word that came forth, Father. Move mighty by your spirit, Holy Ghost. Move mighty in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, bless your people like never before. Increase our focus in you, Father. Let us keep our eyes on the prize, on the mark, which is the high calling, which is in Christ Jesus, God. Let us remain focused even more, even more, even the more, even more and more focused, dear God. In the name of Jesus, God, we thank you in advance. We love you, God. We worship you, and we praise you. It's in Jesus' holy and masterful name we pray. Amen. 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 Hallelujah. Again, thank you for joining us on this Resurrection Sunday. If anyone is going to need prayer after we log off on Facebook Live, you can come to the altar for prayer. If you wish to join the ministry, the altar is also open to be a part of this great and awesome ministry where we're going to love you real good. We're going to love you with the love of Christ. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. This is a no judgment zone. But listen to this, though. Because we say we don't judge you, doesn't give you a right to do and act any kind of way in our presence. Don't get it twisted, baby. Just because we ain't judging you, don't disrespect us.
That's right.
Oh, God. And the same thing applies when it comes to God. You can't live any kind of way and think God don't know. You can't practice sin. You can't. I know about grace and mercy. I know grace. I know we're saved by grace. But you can't use that as an excuse to continue to walk in sin. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. God says, God forbid. God forbid if you think you can continue to walk like that and do those things that you know you ain't got no business doing and think that it's okay. It's one thing when you don't know, but it's a whole nother thing when you know and you continue to live a reckless life. You're taking a chance. Every day you living like that, you're taking a chance. Because tomorrow ain't promised to none of us.
None of us.
None of us. We think we got time. Everybody think they got time. But nobody know the day nor the hour when God is going to call you home. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. I love you guys with the love of Christ. God bless y'all. Y'all have a blessed remaining Resurrection Sunday day. Yes. Y'all make sure y'all eat real good here, because I'm going to eat good.
Amen.
I pray you are too. Amen. Amen. I love y'all with the love of Christ. Have a blessed day.